Okay, good afternoon, everyone. We're here for draw three of the Direct Horizontal Drilling Fall Classic. Our feature game today is Ted Appleman versus John Morris. Guys, we're just a little late getting started, so we're just watching Team Morris finish up their practice session, and then they'll do to the draw to the button. Team Appleman covered the pin on skip stones, and on third stones, we have a rough measurement of about 1 centimeter, we figure. So we'll just watch this here and we'll get started here in a couple of minutes. Okay, so with that draw slipping just behind the button, Team Appleman will start with the hammer.
We have a very exciting matchup here between Team Appleman and Team John Morris. Yeah. On other sheets, we have Slachinski versus Gunnlaugsson in the B event, Cordy versus Laycock in the A event, Liu versus King in the B event, Botcher versus Liburn in the A event, and Ackerman versus Jacobson in the B event, also happening down here at the Crestwood Curling Club.
Whoa!
Lead Rick Swatsky with the first stone. Looks like they're calling this one into the house.
It's in.
Hard. Got judged quicker than that, guys. That was in the whole way. Yeah. Good.
And the first one slides a little deep. I think they wanted that one up front based on Johnny Moe's commentary.
Looks like we'll be exchanging stones here for a bit in the first end.
Good control.
Yep.
Hard. So a tie. You're going when you're sweeping. You're going like this. Sorry. When you're. Yep.
Whoa.
Easy takeout there by Adam Enright. Heard this is his second game of the year. First one was this morning, and apparently he curled 100%. Coming out hot right out of the blocks.
Were those his percentages that he kept himself?
No, that was Tom's percentage. So he was getting glowing reviews from his third there. So it looks like we're going to have a pretty easy first end. Unless somebody misses a wide open takeout, which at this level you don't see very often.
Clean. Go tight.
The Appleman brothers are back curling together for the first time in a few years. Tom spent a number of years playing for Team Botcher, who is also out here, and they decided to get back together and put in a team with their longtime friend Adam Enright. Sean Donnelly, who is a local curler as well. So we'll see how they do this this weekend. They're looking for big things this year. Just exchanging stones up and down the ice here, getting a feel for how the ice is curling, and just getting their game legs underneath them.
Yep. All right.
You'll notice Team Appleman good. Sporting the Oilers-inspired curling uniforms, which has made us up in the booth very happy. We have Donnelly supporting the Lucic George Laroque jersey. We have Adam Enright in the Craig McTavish Jordan Eberle. We have Skip Ted Appleman in the Ryan Nugent Hopkins, and third Tom Appleman wearing the Connor McDavid-inspired number 97.
Tom must have been the one that got to pick the numbers.
Yes, according to the boys, they gave Tom his first choice, and of course he went with Captain Connor.
Good.
Johnny Moe out there, giving some bit of wisdom
hard.
To young Tyrell Griffith on his sweeping techniques.
Hard on him, hard.
Makes Johnny Moe one of the best in the game. He's been there, done that.
Well, I'm not sure what happened there, but that's a flash there on the inside by Tom Appleman.
What turn?
Very, very uncharacteristic of Tom. He's a very good thrower.
Yeah, not sure if that picked something, but they were yelling right out of his hand, so maybe he slid just a bit tight.
Now, without the hammer, Johnny Moe looks like he's going to try to protect that rock in the house. Very hard to make these perfect to the point where they don't have access to them. So still could be looking at a blank here, but definitely a little more interesting with that miss.
Clean it.
Clean. Little bit for weight. Little
keep
bit
it
for
there,
weight.
Swat.
Hard line, too. Hard line.
Swat.
Gotta go. Gotta go. Hard.
Over and off.
Over and off.
Well, good.
Yep. Shit, I thought it was right up.
High guard there. I think Appleman board? Might be able to get around it with board weight or so and get it out of play.
Oh, you want to play this?
Yeah, line on that was not bad, but definitely a lot higher than they were hoping.
Think you can kill it? No? Okay.
Actually, looks like they're gonna play the come around here.
Yeah, I think they're just gonna try to bump it out at the 4 foot, just with back Ava Wade-ish.
But it seems like the more difficult of the two turns to make that shot, does it not?
Yeah, but he's going to want to keep his shooter. It's a little easier probably to keep his shooter in behind the guard.
Yes. That is why you're the third and I'm the lead.
Whoa then. No.
Looks a little heavy here. They're calling back
hard,
line.
Hard at him.
I'm going to want to at least move this out of the from behind
keep
the
going,
guard.
Keep going.
Oof, not going to like those. Now they'll be in big trouble here.
Yeah, not Tom's best best pair there. I'm
no, he won't. He won't like those. Yeah.
Very un-Connor-like, but we'll look for a big rebound in the second end by Tom.
I think the speed's... I think the speed's not bad here. I think right there.
So looks like Johnny Mo is calling for the straight come around.
Yeah, I think he'll try to freeze right on top of that
top
one.
Top eight, if the line's good, we freeze.
And there, you heard it.
Jim Cotter throwing the skip stones for Team Morris, as is become very commonplace with any team that Johnny Moe's on.
It's a tighter pass. It shouldn't be too bad. Okay.
Whoa! Line's good! Line's good! Room! Room! Whoa, whoa! Room! Too much room!
Looking like this one needs to curl a little bit. It seems to be hanging on him.
Yeah, I think there's a little bit more weight here than they're hoping for.
Fuck, we gotta be short first and then we fail.
So it looks like this will give Ted a chance to get rid of both both blues.
You wanna get rid of both or you wanna nose it? I don't know, I just want to get rid of them. Well, I either want to blast it or nose it. What do you think? Nose it, we shot for two, maybe. Nose it right here, what's he do? He's got to get him. Oh, and then I might be able to hit it with the outturn.
You don't think if you throw it normally, you can stick around?
Well, we could try. Yeah, we could try. That's fine. Well, we got to hit it here, right?
Two-thirds you got to get.
Thing is, with normal, we're hitting this pretty thin. I don't know if that gets out. So am I throwing normal then?
Yeah. Whatever you want. If you want to blast
him, I think we just get rid of him. I don't want to get cute. I want to make sure that goes. No matter what he does, we can get it out. Yeah. I think just get rid of him.
So looks like Skip Ted Appleman is looking for just kind of like, normal weight double here, I think.
Yeah, he's going to try to make the double, and they talked about trying to save the shooter or trying to nose it, but...
I think Tom's right. I think if I throw normal, it'd be close.
Well, I think you want to save the shooter here because you don't want to give Team Morris a chance to make that come around again.
Yeah, I think they're thinking with the long guard, they probably can get at it, and if he doesn't make it perfect, they might get the blank out. They got to make sure they move both of these here, so... They're definitely going to try to get as much as they can and see if they can hang that shooter out on the side of the 12 foot. Party is to get rid of both blues, though. This needs to curl up a bit for him.
And just spins enough.
I might curl him more.
Yeah, good enough to get rid of the two blues. With that kind of weight, I definitely think he could have made the double and stuck it out in the 12 foot, but...
Yeah, it was a little wide, there.
Yeah, they were... they'll take that after the way things were looking after Tom's second one there.
Still a pretty good chance here for Team Cotter to bury one. It is a high guard, but will definitely make the blank quite difficult if he's able to sink this one. Should be close here. He just threw the exact same pass, so I look for a good one here out of Jim Cotter.
Line's good. Hard line. Hard line. Hard line, guys, gotta be in. Looks light.
Definitely got less weight here this time.
Can you bite it? Can you bite it? I got it, Swan, I got it. Can you bite it? Come on, get a biter. Come on.
Really working this one hard.
Trying to
get
a piece
it in.
Yeah.
I don't like these rocks. I don't like them. I didn't like them in practice.
Ooh, got away with that one.
Yeah. Team Appleman pretty fortunate to have a free shot at a blank here after a couple of misses from on third stones, but they'll take the blank end and we'll start again next in end number two.
Team Morris having a discussion on rocks here. Okay, Jim Cotter does not seem like he likes his two stones,
okay, boys,
perhaps not quite matched evenly.
Well, you wouldn't expect him to throw that same shot twice there and to not even hit the house. So
no,
it's a possibility they might have fallen into a different path because John was saying he was tight early. So that could be a few things there. But if there's any doubt in your minds, you might as well just get rid of him.
Yeah, give it to the lead. I always get the crappy rocks.
That's the way it goes.
But, you know, a man of my skill and ability, I just make it work.
And I threw the 8 first and third. Oh, the 7 first and third.
No, not awesome. But textbook blank, eh? Textbook blank.
So Team Morris will be leading off the end. I didn't see what he called here. See if he puts one up front or throws one in the house. I would guess he'd be looking for a guard here and to get real aggressive.
Whoa, Jim. Just clean. Yep. Yep.
You know what they're looking for there? Halfway guard right in the center line. So good. I would assume that Ted will come right in behind.
Sweep is
line's good. Lots of room. Where are we? Okay.
Lead Adam Enright looking to keep his perfect spiel alive. So far he's curling 100% for the spiel. And that will slid maybe a little deep, but I'd still probably give him 100% on that one. Generally want to keep that about top four, maybe biting the button, but that's a little deep in this type of curling.
Definitely a couple of feet too deep, and we'll see Team Morris here play the freeze.
No backing. Line's good.
Weight's good.
Jim. Line's good. Oh, no bounce. Tie. Whoa. Get close. Nice shot, Swat.
Yeah, really nice there. They'll like that one.
Throw the same.
Really, really same. Important how you set up the angles here with the type of weight that these guys can throw. You really need to know your angles and know how you can get out of the end if you need to bail.
Gotta wait. Hard. Hard! Line's great now. Hard, guys. Line's good. Right down to it.
Very nice shot by Adam Enright there. Just giving himself a little bit of room by unlocking the back one. And pretty much nose freezing, making that rock very, very difficult to remove.
Line's good. Just right here, Swat. Yep, for line, yep.
Three.
Hard. Really hard.
Just tight.
Hard. Whoa. Stay close. Yep. Got a bit of an angle here.
A little tight and light there. Not what Johnny Moe was looking for.
They're having a little bit of trouble figuring it out. I'm not sure if there's a couple of spots on the ice or it's just, you know, pebble worn off in a few different spots, but there's a bit of confusion there.
Yep.
Looking for the double peel of the front here. Well done by Mr. Sean Donnelly.
Same weight.
So second Tyrell Griffith with his first of the end, second of
two
the
thirds.
End.
Two-thirds.
Second of the end.
Let it work, Jim. Got to get to the center line hard. Really got to go. Get a better angle. Get a better angle. Yeah. Yeah. Hard. Hard. Go, 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 go. Got to go really hard. Got to go really hard. Get to that line. Shot.
Pretty close. I think they wanted that to curl maybe an extra inch or two, but pretty tough to make the perfect guard here.
Yep, yep. Yep, hard.
Yeah, really have to go in this
hard.
Corner. Have to get it by the guard.
Hard, gotta go.
They're holding it pretty
Tom.
Good.
Hard. Go. Right to it. Right to it. Keep
good
going,
sweep
going,
there
going,
by the boys.
Going.
Not the best angles there on the top.
Overcurled a hair on them. They wanted to definitely maintain that angle to keep those reds onto the blue.
Yep. Almost edge.
So John can put a good one in here and kind of lock up that 4 foot pretty good.
It's top eight. Top eight.
Robert's here.
I don't think you want to guard. Top eight.
Special guest in the booth, Robert Odegaard, a lifetime member here at the Crestwood. And father to our very own Tiffany Odegaard.
Should be close. Should be
no
close.
Best. Got rail.
Wait only.
Oh, Johnny Moe here looking to freeze right into the pocket of those. Got to be good here.
Whoa.
Weight looks pretty close, I think. Oh, maybe they're deciding to leave it high.
Yeah, I think it was curling a bit on them, so they kind of got off it, just trying to leave it a bit higher and keep what they can. Might be able to play that red onto the blue, roll his shooter away and sit a few... potentially buried in the forefoot.
Ward. You like this? Because we might just leave the shooter here. Got to roll the shooter off. Show this. Easy hit. Hit what you can see.
Skip Ted Appleman calling for... just the maybe down normal, hit what you can see, wants to roll the shooter out a
go
little
board.
Ways as it doesn't
board.
Leave anything
board.
For Team Morris. He's now changed his mind to throw board weight, so a little down.
Whoa! Whoa! Yep! Hard! Whoa! Hard! Whoa! Whoa!
Looks close here.
Whoa! Yep! Hard at him! Hard at him! Hard at him!
Kind of maybe lost that one a hair. They wanted to roll that shooter just another couple
so
of rocks
here, if we can kick
to get it
there,
past that red so he could make
us,
this
right?
double to leave the blue buried. So
like the outturn here.
If John makes this, they'll all of a sudden be sitting pretty good here. So could be a couple of big swings this end.
They are line four, but against a team like John Morris, you don't want to leave them shots like this that can swing the end around in a hurry.
I think he'll be throwing this one pretty hard.
Half.
You heard them talking, trying to slide into the middle of the two reds. If he does that, he should sit directly in line with his other blues. And it'll be tough for Team Appleman to get rid of.
Yeah, big shot here coming up. If he doesn't make this, we could be looking at a big end for Ted Appleman. You'd expect a guy like John Morris to be pretty close here. So.
Oh yeah, he'll be close on this one.
Whoa!
Yep. Throwing the 6 second peel here.
Curl.
A bit thin there. He had to be. He had to be a little thicker there and keep his shooter from rolling back out into the open here.
Same.
So looking for a very, very similar throw from from Tom here. Just board weight. Looking to roll this one away here, Steven? Or?
Yeah, you bet. They'll try to get that shooter out wide into the 8-foot, into the 12-foot.
Wider. As long as it hangs around for a third shot, they'd be pretty happy.
No, never,
this.
Never. Yeah. Hard at him.
He's going to have to curl up a hair for him.
Hard at him. Hard at him.
Seems to be hanging a little bit.
Curled a bit. That's a pretty good shot there. I got the jam in the back.
Yeah, unfortunate to get that jam.
So they'll only sit one in the top of the 4-foot there, but it's pretty buried.
Yeah, not easy to get at, and Team Morris with the one lonely blue one at the back of the 8-foot.
Yeah, I think either that or the outturn for
the outturn, either or. Either turn.
Key shot here coming up for Team Morris.
I think so. Even here is not like.
What?
You know,
we got to be beating these two out.
Yeah.
It's curling pretty good here, Jim. It won't be like last time. Last time was quick and straighter.
Yeah.
This is going to be like probably 4 to 5 feet heavier and curl another foot at least.
Okay.
Veteran Johnny Moe reading the ice here and letting Skip Stones know that he thinks it's going to be a little slower and maybe curl a little bit more
shot,
on the
actually.
First end.
I think that's the shot.
Sure.
I think come back and change the
this
call
will be more
again.
Like practice.
Other one, I like this.
Guys seem to like this.
Got to be real careful here, though. If you don't make the freeze perfect, if you bounce off at all, you're probably leaving a double for
Hard
Team
line.
Appleman to
line
4.
Hard line.
Yep.
This is curling.
Whoa.
This is trouble already. I'm trying to keep that blue up there somewhere where he can stay in front of his blue in the back.
Not very good. Uncharacteristic of Jim Cotter to struggle that much with his draw weight.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah, I'm not sure that. I think that spot's curling maybe a little more than John thinks based on.
Yeah.
In the first end there, Reynolds straighter. Typically it loosens up and we see a little bit more curl here after the first end or first few rocks. So might have just caught him by surprise a bit on that one. Weight was perfect by the looks of it.
Just full 4. Because if we go any deeper, he'll just freeze to us, right? Yeah, we got to do this. I'd like to hit that open one, but if he sinks one in, we're not scoring.
So Ted Appleman here is looking for the straight come around. He could
so
hit
back
the back blue one to lie 4, but doesn't want to leave the come around for Team Morris to get him out of the end. So look for a good come around here, and he's going to force Team Morris to do something special.
Felt light. Whatever you think. Line's good.
Saying line's good.
Line's good. Yep.
Weight looks close.
Harshon! Well then.
Just hair in the guard here, getting a lot of finish here.
Whoa. Oh. Sit!
That's pretty sit, decent
guys.
There, I
Good
think.
Spot.
Yeah, it's not easy. If they tried to make a play on that one, you have a possible jam opportunity at the back. So, be interesting to see what Team Morris does here.
Yeah, there doesn't look like a ton of great options.
You see enough of this? Hit it onto it?
It's probably our
might have to
probably
bring,
our best
bring some blue one of the blues back
Freeze
into them.
Freeze sucks. The tap is almost impossible. I think that's our best option with like hack weight.
Yep.
I'm just throwing hack weight here and just trying to leave that blue almost
Hack weight, just
right
shave
into
that
the,
first one.
Yeah. Right into the middle of the two reds there.
Yeah, if this...
It'd be tough to sit shot, but if they get in there for second...
This isn't made properly. This could be a big end here for Team Appleman.
Yeah, this is kind of weight that's a bit tricky here, that hack weight, because it could take off on him or curl lots, or if he's up a hair, it'll track a little bit straighter. So.
What's that? We're hitting the one behind the center, the outturn one. Like half. I won't be quiet.
Yeah, real tricky here. You got to throw the right weight, or this will not do what they think it will. So.
Wow.
No, they call the weights up a bit.
Clean. Yep, yep.
They think it's close.
Hard, hard, hard squat.
This
hard.
Tight to the guard.
Oof. Disaster.
Just feathers the guard.
Now, are they able to get at this back blue one here for a pile?
I don't think so. I think they'll just play the draw for three here.
Play that for four?
Ted looking at the double off his own for four.
If I just roll it in, it's not bad.
I like it.
So peel right there.
Real aggressive.
He's saying if he's a little bit thick, it should just roll in for the three anyways.
I don't got to throw...
The danger here would be nosing it.
Hard or just regular peel?
Yeah, you don't get a lot of chances to score multiple points on a team like John Moore. So,
You know, three would be really big here. He just threw the draw. Four is always nice, but
play the double for four. Yeah.
Ted's certainly not afraid to throw the high hard one here. So he's pretty comfortable in this.
Teddy's a bit of a riverboat gambler. He loves to go for broke, whether it's at the curling rink or on the golf course. He is also a fairly accomplished golfer. However, he does have a very hard time winning any money off myself anytime we get out there to play. So.
Oh. Yep. Whoa. 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 Close.
It's close.
Oh, see, the one thing that he couldn't do there was play the nose hit. So Ted tries a big tough shot for four, ends up getting two.
Still
take a 2-0 lead here.
Still good, but you got to think Team Morris is pretty happy with that outcome considering the way the end played out.
Yeah, they're in trouble for most of that end. And
Good. So
Team Appleman with the first rock of the end.
Can't have that back button.
Sliding a little deep there. That will bring Adam Enright's percentage down to about 98% for the speed.
Yeah.
Halfway.
Johnny Moe calling for the corner guard with... with Adam Enright's first one sliding a little deep there. They're going to play it real aggressive and look to set up a big end here. That one's a little higher than I think they would have liked it. That's with this type of ice and stones, that's pretty easy to get at anything that might come around that. So
yeah, definitely would have been looking to have that 3 or 4 feet tighter. But not a lot of danger for him with the first rock of Team Appleman slipping deep.
Okay.
Little just off-center guard here.
Yeah, that's not what they're looking for. Now Team Morris can use that as a corner with some something behind the T-line behind it. So good opportunity here for Team Morris to start building an end.
They're going to look for something top four, either fully buried or partially buried. This one looks like it needs to curl quite a bit here.
It's back here,
yep, back here,
him.
Yep. Hard, Jim, hard, hard, hard. Jesus Christ.
Not good. That is the unpreferred miss there. Better to be a little light than deep.
Yeah.
Second, Sean Donnelly with his first of the end.
Hard!
Looking for the board weight takeout here. Looking like he might be a little narrow. This one seems to really be curling on him. We'll see if the sweepers can hold it. And they can't. So a couple misses in a row here from both teams.
A bit of a slow start to this end. And neither team will be very happy with how this end started up, but...
I don't know what to do.
Johnny Moe seems perplexed by the amount of subpar curling shots and the way that this end is setting up for him.
Yeah, it's still early in the end. They still have a chance to get some things set up here. So, yeah, it's only seconds first stone. So he's got a guard, albeit a high one. He's got two rocks behind the tee line. So he's going to try to put up a tighter guard in behind that corner, give him some options.
Where is he?
Two-thirds.
Get it in, SWAT. Get it in. SWAT, you're in. Yes. Just bite.
Bit of
just
an
bite.
Audible here. He's now calling for it to come in. This one's definitely in. That was quite a bit deep for what they called, but in not a bad spot.
It's still pretty good. At least half buried back in there, so...
Yeah, anytime you gotta go out this wide, definitely makes it tricky. Visually, it's not the easiest shot.
Yep. Yep. Hard. Whoa! 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 Whoa!
Really nice shot there by Sean Donnelly. Gets the one that was in the 12-foot and manages to slide over, make contact with the two in the house. So pretty good shot there.
Yeah, and a good opportunity here for Morris. They can play the corner freeze on that one red. It'll be tough to get rid of. So.
Need a good one here if they are looking to set up a multiple score here.
Guys think this one's a bit light here. They're pounding it out of his hand.
This looks quite a bit light.
I got it.
Yeah.
Whoa. Whoa. Yep. Whoa. 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 No, no. Shot.
Nice shot there by Tom. Just a little off-center hit and sitting right at the top of the 12, just biting the center line. So still leaves the freeze opportunity for John Morris to make it well, but does at least have some options, something he can run back if needed. First stone for John Morris in the third end.
Make sure it's for clean. Make sure we're shot, Swat.
Yeah.
Make sure, yes, hard.
Hard line.
This one appears to be over curling on him. They liked it out of his hand.
Hard. Bounce it in.
Bounce it in.
Must have fooled him a little bit.
Hard.
Got no clue.
Yeah, weight was close there. He would have been top four, top button. Maybe just top eight. So
same
Johnny Mo is not happy with that throw.
Oh, it's good shot, my boy.
Another solid throw by Tom Appleman. He has rebounded nicely after a couple uncharacteristic misses in the first end.
Yeah, force John here to play the double peel, just get rid of those reds up front and open up the 4 foot for him.
Out turn! Yep. Whoa.
Heart.
Not exactly what Johnny was looking for there.
No, but not bad. End up kind of kicking both of those reds into the open there and leaves himself sitting third shot. Not ideal by any means, but
draw right here.
Team Appleman will have to be a little bit careful here. Still want to line anything up for him so that Team Morris can bring that back blue one into play.
Yeah, looked like he was really trying to put a little extra on that one and might have just pitched her a little bit outside. So Ted Appleman with his first one.
Top four. What do you think?
Looking to play the come around. Just wants a top four. Should leave a short run back, possible double for Team Morris, but we'll see what happens.
Like, it's not going to be as quick as this drive through here. Okay. Okay. It's a lot of ice. Okay. So 14 and a quarter? Oh, okay. Okay, boys. Top four.
Looks good.
Okay, line's really good. Whoa. Line's fine. Top four. Room. Wait. Whoa.
This one looks pretty close here.
Whoa. Got lots of weight, guys. Whoa. It's too deep.
Slides a little deep. Not bad, but a little deep.
Yeah. Slid just 2 feet deep there. If he's on that line, top 8 foot, it's a pretty good shot.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So some options now here from Team Morris for Jim Cotter.
Yeah.
like a back line-ish.
Okay, this one got curling early on them again. They rubbed the guard here. Tap that into the side of the T-line. I think just a bit of trouble getting the broom in the right spot right now for Team Morris.
Just put it right here, don't you? He's got to throw the hit and roll.
Yeah, Ted makes a good one here. That's going to be a pretty small scoring area for Cotter to find.
Got to throw the hit and roll or out-turn draw.
Right now, Red looks to be line three and throwing, which
yeah, where did I throw good?
Is always a good spot if you're a Team Appleman fan.
Yeah, okay, just outside edge 8, because we don't have to touch center. We want to just bite the forefoot.
Yeah, bite the top of the forefoot here, half buried behind that blue.
Yeah,
or yeah, I guess wide open
air,
even.
Bite the four. So
just biting the center line probably, so he can't get a hair inside. And might have to play that hit and roll off the one on the T line out in the side into back into the forefoot.
A bit less.
Which definitely would be a bit of a guess for him with the
got
broom.
Got to wait for line. It's way out there.
That path yet.
This one looks
line's
like
really
it needs
good.
To curl
yep.
a bit.
Hartson, Hartson,
getting better.
Come on, gotta go, boys. Gotta
really
go.
Really, just about anywhere.
Right to four. Go.
From 8 foot to 4 foot, it's gonna really make it difficult for Team Morris.
Yeah, just a hair light there might give him the option to play the same kind of a shot here. Yeah, just kind of caught in between there. That line's good if it's 2 feet deeper. So. Cotter will have a chance just to play a quiet tap here, move that one out of the forefoot and stick around for the single.
Same way.
Yeah, teams have kind of been handing each other chances back and forth and just waiting for one team to really take advantage of it. We'll see here, though. They've seen a few overcurls with his down weight, so see if they can get the broom in the right spot.
Whoa! Clean!
This looks close.
Yep!
He's through the really nice weight here. Yeah, very nice shot there. Nice, quiet takeout there for one by Jim Cotter. So Team Morris picks up the single, and they'll trail 2-1 going to the fourth end.
So we'll give you a quick scoring update here. On a sheet directly in front of us, we have Team Liburn and Team Botcher tied at 2. Team Botcher took 2 in the first. Team Liburn got 1 in the second and stole 1 in the third, and they are currently playing the fourth end. Over on the next sheet, we have Slachinski and Gunlufsen, and it was 2-0 for Gunlufsen. They took 2 in the first, and we've had a couple blanks in a row. Over on our next sheet, we have Team King and Team Liu knotted at 1s. At the far end, we have Team Laycock playing Corti, and it is currently 2-1 for Team Laycock. And over on the other sheet, it's a little too far away for me to see right now, but according to our board, we have Team Jacobson up 2-1 on Team Ackerman. And now you're up to date on all the scores. Team Morris looking for the center guard to start the end. Looks like it might be over curling slightly, but pretty good. Team Appleman looking for the come around here.
Line's good. Line's good. Got lots of room. Lots of room. Yeah, line's perfect. Coming in nice. Shot, Adam. Oh boy. Okay.
So a pretty good shot there from lead Adam Enright. Might have slipped a couple inches too deep, but pretty good. This one looks like it needs to curl a bit. Seems to be hanging on him.
Hackway.
So looking for the hack weight takeout. Maybe get a hair under.
Yep.
Don't want to leave an easy double.
Hard. Hard. Hard.
This one hard, really seems to be curling on him here.
Hard. Hard.
Just rubs the top.
Yep.
Looks like Team Morris is just looking for about a halfway guard here, protecting their stone just full in the forefoot.
Right even with that one.
And, pretty good spot there. Team Appleman looking for the potential double peel here. Pretty hard to lose the shooter, should still probably have something up front, but we'll see.
Shot. Oh boy.
And I was wrong for the first time in my life. They were able to lose the shooter.
Good weight, Ty. Same weight.
See the guard go back up.
Looking to just replace where the previous stone ended up. That was in a pretty good spot there.
They're higher. We're good. Weight's good. Weight's good. Halfway.
And a real nice shot there by second Tyrell Griffith.
Stick it right off.
Looking to just peel this one off here.
Yeah, a couple of good throws there.
Yeah, a little bit more wide open here. Teams just kind of throwing her up and down. Maybe a little bit to do with them struggling to find the correct broom positions and a little bit with the ice out there. So.
Yeah, I think Appleman shot rock, so at some point I think they're figuring that Team Morris will have to make a play in the rings
and
sit shots. So
Line's good.
Might set up a double for them and still leave them with a blank opportunity.
Line's good.
Definitely be hoping to score your deuce here. If they could take a 4-1 lead, that would certainly
good.
be big for them halfway
right,
through this
bit.
Game.
Yep.
So,
T-line!
Team Appleman switching up a little bit and are going to make a move on the Bluestone just full in the forefoot here. Just looking to tap it back four and probably sit kind of close to right on top of theirs.
Okay, whoa, easy, close, whoa, yep, hard.
This one looks to be pretty close here.
Whoa, just for Wade if he needs it.
Really, really good shot there by Tom Appleman. Still a chance here for Johnny Moe to get rid of this red rock and flip a little bit undercover. And if he does that, they'll be sitting pretty good.
Yeah, if he can make this roll right underneath, it'll be tough for Team Appleman to get rid of it. May have to play the guard back. And might be a good opportunity to steal here.
This one looks
whoa.
To be pretty close
yeah.
here.
Whoa!
Just about. Silver swept it a hair. That could have been, that was very close. Looks like they'll just rip the double here now, lose their shooter, and sit their one.
Yeah, if you make the double here.
Get in here!
You're not in a bad
just
spot
peel.
Sitting, just biting the forefoot, pretty much fully buried.
Whoa!
They're just a hair thin. Had to get that one. Now that leaves Team Morris shot in the back there. Jim Cotter will have a chance to play the corner freeze on the top one.
Yeah, looked like a lot of weight there. I don't know if he necessarily needed to throw quite that much weight.
Yeah, corner freeze there. What are you thinking here?
So Jim Cotter here looking to just freeze on Appleman's redstone, just biting the forefoot here.
Hard, guys.
Definitely needs to make a good one here. Two could still potentially be in play.
Hard.
This one looks a little short. It's not in a bad spot, not exactly where they want it, but definitely not in a bad spot for him.
That's a shot, eh? And because if he hangs it at all, we'll have a shot for three.
He's going to guard.
Well, then we draw for two, right?
Yeah.
Where's that? Oh, if I off of that?
Straight double.
Ooh, if I go here? I don't think so. Wasn't that a straight jam? Even if he makes it, though, then I draw for one, right?
So.
Like,
we're gonna draw on the side of the park.
Yeah, I think so.
What gets us to the fun, NJ?
I'd say right here, right now.
Okay, well, we got a good play back.
Yeah, that's what I like right here.
So Ted's looking to just draw side of the button, partially get
a
little bit tucked behind the Stone Morris team. Morris
we gotta
just
be good full four to get shot. Like we gotta be touching white.
Definitely looking to be shot so rock here and force Jim Cotter to make a move on it.
Like he just threw his light. So you think it's that quick? Same as this side? Okay. Okay, boys. Line's good. Easy if you can. Easy if you can. Go then. Line's great, guys. Come on.
I think they're really going to have to go on this one.
Keep going. You got to get past that blue. Keep going.
Yeah, the guys didn't like that one right out of his hand.
Yeah, just looked light all the way.
Yeah. Is this any good? Yes, I agree. Yeah, I like that. Throw the out at it. Throw the guard.
So just gonna play the guard, try to make that draw as tough as possible. Might have a chance to steal with that one in the back.
Right.
So it looks like Team Morris is just gonna throw up a guard here and try to cut off the path for Appleman's last rock here.
So just trying to block the path as much as possible here, I guess.
Yeah, just trying to make that intern draw a little bit more difficult here.
Yeah, this didn't come up and curl over that line as much as they were hoping, I don't think.
Yep.
No, that intern draw should still be there all day.
It's just...
Look for Ted here to give it a little bit more and hopefully take his one and move to the fifth end with a 3-1 lead.
I like it.
Line's good. T line.
Sweepers seem to like this one a little bit more.
Line's good. Line's
starting
good.
To go on her.
Just sweep for T. Well, room. Room!
This one looks close here. This one's up to the sweepers to make it good.
Yeah, line's good.
A real good throw there by Ted.
Yep.
So one red, and we will move to the fifth then with Team Appleman up 3-1 on Team Morris. So as we move into the fifth end here, we'd like to take the time to thank our sponsors that make this event possible. Without their help and support, we would not be able to host such a wonderful event. So big shout out to our sponsors at Homestead Developments, Integrity Movers, Granville Island Brewing, Michelob Ultra and Labatt, NWT Promotions, Prison Engineering, Rise Promotions, Zender Ford, and of course our title sponsor, Direct Horizontal Drilling. We can't thank you enough for your participation in this event and your continued support of it. So thanks to all of our sponsors, and hopefully any of you out there listening will show them some love and support so they keep writing us big checks. Team Appleman looking to play the probably halfway to tight center guard.
Line's good.
The one they just threw there.
Okay, easy. Easy. No. Whoa. Okay.
Pretty good pair there from Adam Enright, playing in his first spiel of the year, showing no signs of rust out there. I've heard he's just finishing up farming season and hasn't had time to throw many rocks. So, good on him for showing up and playing as well as he has. Johnny Moe calling for the little tap back here. Just going to move it back 8 foot. Pretty good shot there.
Hackway.
Team Appleman looking to play a very similar shot to what Team Morris did. Just calling for hack weight and hit as much as you can. And hopefully get rid of it, but if nothing else, at least move it behind the tee line.
Hard! Whoa!
This one really seems to be moving here.
Whoa! Just for weight. It needs weight. Keep going.
That's a really good shot there by second Sean Donnelly. Like Team Morris is hoping for the board weight hit and roll behind their own corner guard here, which if made well could definitely set up a deuce opportunity for him.
Overcurled a bit on him there, but the nose hit, still not a bad shot there. Team Appleman will have to deal with it.
Easy weight.
So I think they're maybe hoping to get a little hit and roll under here. Calling for just kind of nice normal. So it might be up a hair, which on this ice generally means it's going to hang a little bit on him.
Christ.
That's not good. That was not what they were looking for.
A good opportunity here now for Team Morris to set up a two, possible three.
There was lots of ways to miss that, and that was not one of them.
I don't mind this.
Draw.
Just over, Barry.
Looks like Team Morris is looking to bring another one in around that kind of high red center guard here. Anything top eight, top four is pretty good here. Pretty good result there.
Good call, I like that.
Team Appleman is in a bit of trouble here. Gonna have to try to get one in there or try to get rid of something.
Yeah, this is that's a very good shot there for Team Morris. Team Appleman have to be careful here.
Looks like Tom's going down there to discuss this. This is a very, very important part in the game here.
You like that? Yeah. Problem is, if
throw it a hair low, get on that side.
If you miss everything and he goes around this corner, in trouble. Giving a three. Because even if you make the double, he's going around the corner again. It's a two. Right?
Yeah. I'm never getting that wrong.
I know. My initial thought was hit this and roll here. And he's got to make that double. If he misses that double, then we could just draw here. If he makes a double, he's probably going to have a shooter there. It'd be a thin double back. But we're still chasing the whole time, aren't we? Okay, well, okay, if you want to try that, I don't mind it. Hit it right on the nose. Well, not really.
So, looks like... looks like Tom's going to try to play the nose double here, I think.
Yeah, the run double. There's not a lot of great options for them right now, so this has the best result if they make it perfect. So.
Big shot here for Tom with a pretty high degree of difficulty anytime you're trying to run back something that high up. Got to be real close here.
No! Out of there, Adam. See if you can get out of there. All right.
Yeah, not what Team Appleman was looking for here. They're still in quite a bit of trouble.
Yeah, Team Morris will be happy to replace that one in the same spot.
We'll see if Johnny Moe's figured out the ice and can put the broom in the right position. Very key on these guards.
Seems to be a little bit more confidence with the Team Morris here in the last few ends. Might have gotten things figured out.
Yeah, it always takes a little bit of getting used to new ice and figuring out what the different spots will do. But certainly for any of these teams, they've played in enough of these that they should be able to make the proper adjustments. And I think you'll see a lot more shots being made in the coming games. This one looks a little deep. I don't think they were wanting it quite that deep.
Yeah, definitely deeper than they thought. Might be an opportunity to get all three of them here.
Yeah, big chance here for Team Appleman. You gotta take advantage when you're given an out here. So hopefully they're able to get at least a couple of them moving, if not all three.
Stay here! Stay here! Yeah.
Look for Tom to be throwing some pretty big weight here. Try to get them moving as much as possible.
Yep! Hard! Hard!
This one looked tight out of
hard,
his hand.
Hard, guys! Hard!
Right to it!
Oh, Thomas.
Had to at least make the top double there. So, really no change in the situation from when John threw his first one. So, a chance to put the better one up.
That was not at all what they were looking for there.
Got same line. Line's good.
Looks to be a little bit better weight here by Johnny Mall.
Yeah, line's good. This will be. Should be a good spot.
Yeah, Ted's got to make something here. Right now it's looking like a two, if not maybe a three for T. Morris.
If you're here, is that any good if you're here?
Well, then he comes onto it. I think it's the run or...
What do you like here, Steve? What?
But if we go here and he makes the boardway double, I'll have the freezer to chop under, right?
Not a lot of options.
No, not a lot. Just having a look there. You could tap the red. You could run the blue back in there. Or you could try.
It'll roll.
You could try the wide out turn draw into the back there.
Oh, so tap it to here. Okay.
Yeah, that run's pretty tough. The tap to me seems like the easier shot. But
yeah, the one thing they're worried about is if they don't tap it right to the right spot, John may have Jim Cotter may have a double and roll away. And he's sitting really good there. So they're going to try to tap this one right onto the back blue and leave it frozen back there.
Yeah, big shot here coming up for Ted.
Yeah, if they, this is a chance a little bit to get out of trouble. And if he were to miss it, there's a really good opportunity for Jim Cotter to make something really good and set themselves up for a big end.
With it. Just got to be a hair on the high side. I'm going to try and give you back eight out of my hand, so it's just a line call. Easy. Okay.
Back ball. Yep. Back line.
Hard. Oh, wow. What the
this
hell?
This is really curling on him.
Whoa.
It's going to do something, move some things around here.
Actually,
I don't know how that rock curl I got.
That's interesting result there. Morris still lies two. And he pushed one of them out into the wide open. So they might have to protect that one.
Are you trying to sit three?
Yeah, that was interesting. Not sure what happened. Ted's not sure either.
Well, it's pretty precise, though.
Did curl a lot.
Just say, if we ended up here. Right. This is actually. Then he runs up.
off of.
Right.
So I think we play the split.
Okay.
So nice. I play the split. Well, the problem is if he knows it, he hits it, rolls in. Our best shot is this. This is the best shot.
Yeah, kind of an interesting situation here. It's really been a bit of a game of misses here. Not really sure what they're talking about. I think John Morris might be having mic troubles. We haven't been able to hear from him in a couple ends, so we have to check the batteries in that thing.
So what did they decide on? They're coming in top eight. I didn't.
The two.
Yeah, I wasn't sure. They were talking about a few different things here.
Yeah, so they could throw the guard, but that leaves the double tap. But maybe there's no good angles there for Team Appleman. We heard them talking about trying to lie three, straight come out turn come around. Yeah, heard come tight top 8 foot and try to guard them that way. So
yeah, the double tap here. The double tap doesn't look like it has the best angles on it for Team Appleman. They could. Definitely get shot out of it, but
they're not calling
ideal.
Heavy here. This is curling.
Yeah, this is not at all what they were looking for. I am
not sure what happened to that
I
one.
I don't know either.
I wonder if that picked because it curled and was gone early. I mean, quite a bit of weight there too, so. Looks like an opportunity here for a double for Ted Appleman to get out of trouble in an end that they looked like they were going to be in big trouble. So it's not easy, not automatic, but it's a better shot than you thought he would have had.
Yeah, they've kind of been handing each other chances back and forth with nobody really taking big advantage of it. So we'll see if Ted can buck that trend and take advantage of some uncharacteristic mistakes here from Team Morris.
Yeah, they even, when they racked the guard there, they pushed the one blue guard in front of the reds, so he'd actually end up sitting two buried here, forcing Jim Cotter to make his draw for one.
Whoa! Yep!
Real nice shot there by Ted Appleman. That's completely changes the
yeah, and with that, he'll force him to make the draw for one. That was a... A lot of twists and turns on the in that end.
Yeah, that's a pretty big momentum swing in Team Appleman's favor. They got to feel just thrilled leaving them an open draw for one here. Jim Cotter struggled a little bit with his draw weight in this game, so we'll see if he can find some nice T-line weight here and score a single and move on to the sixth end. It looks like they lost this one, too.
Yeah, something happened to this one, too. Yeah, it looked like he might have grabbed something, and they weren't concerned about weight or line there most of the way down, and that ends up over-curling and racking on top of the red ones.
That's a steal of two. Johnny Moe not happy. So a real big swing there. Steal of two for Team Appleman, and they now lead 5-1 over Team Morris playing the sixth end. Look for this one to be in the house here. Team Appleman's going to look to play a little conservative and at the worst give up a deuce here. So. Tim Morris will look to throw up a corner. Probably see a couple corners here being being down four. Not a bad spot. Maybe slid a hair deep, but definitely usable.
Oh yeah, he'll like that one.
And Team Appleman calling my favorite shot the old throw through. I'm 100% on those in my life. Not very often you see the throw-through in the sixth end, but with a team like Morris, any rocks in play can be used against you. So pretty smart call there, I think.
Yeah, they're happy with Adam Enright's first one. They're just biting the top of the forward right in the center line. Pretty good spot. So anything else there would probably have helped Team Morris. So that's why we see the throw-through, and then we'll start to see the peels for the rest of this end from Team Appleman.
Clean. Yep. Good throw.
And, looks pretty good there by second Sean Donnelly. And yeah, makes the peel and gets rid of the shooter.
So we do have our first final of this draw over on sheet five. It was Team Gunlinson with a 6-2 victory over Team Slachinski. After six ends.
Team Morris looking to just replace the corner guards. It was just peeled off by Team Appleman. I think you'll see this maybe one or two more times, and you'll see Team Morris have to make a move into the rings here.
Clean. Throw it, Sean.
Another real good throw there by Sean, making both his peels. Looks like Team Morris gonna try to go around the corner here. I thought they might wait a rock or two, but clearly Johnny Moe knows a lot better than I do. So
nice wait there. They didn't get the finish they were hoping for. It should still be. Probably three quarters open, maybe half.
Team Appleman looking to get rid of that. Definitely the pro side miss here is a little tight if you were to get rid of that corner. Certainly not the end of the world, just definitely don't want to be wide here. Catches just enough to get rid of that, and Team Morris will try to make it just a little better this time.
Thank you.
Back here. Go, Ty.
This one looks pretty good. More important that they get it real buried than keeping it above the tee line.
Just
don't want to give them any way to get at it.
Straight peel. Give it a go. Okay.
Just nutted the run.
So looks like Team Appleman's just going to play the straight peel here, which with a 4-point lead, I think is the smart call.
Clean, clean. Throw, Tom.
Even if you give Team Morris two here, being up 5-3 with only two to play is a pretty good spot to be in. Throw there by John Morris and leaves them sitting two. Not a great angle for the double. We'll see what Team Appleman does here.
He does, I should have a double.
Yeah.
Or you want to try and go for it now?
No.
It's pretty thin.
Yeah.
We threw one earlier here. Didn't do much, eh? So I think I can get just control.
Now, Steve, why would they be hitting this back one here?
Well, what they're going to try to do is, Ted mentioned here, if they nose it, and then with Jim Cotter's next one, regardless if he would nose or pretty much anywhere
actually,
he rolled, Ted would have a chance
at
a double.
Doesn't he freeze to it if we nose it?
I was just going to say, the only concern would be is if he
probably
noses
it. Probably
going
to try the double here, hey?
Cotter could play the freeze, and then he would have to hit the open one.
We got to hit this one.
Yeah, I think
he's
gonna
freeze to that
here.
If I nose it.
Yeah, I think that's a smart call. I mean, if they roll over towards that other blue one, makes
the
roll for
Team
Morris a little trickier, and could still possibly leave them a double. So
He's definitely gonna want to try to be shot rock after this one.
Yeah,
so you have to roll a bit, bit towards the center line.
Whoa now, close. Whoa.
That's pretty good right there from Ted Appleman.
Yeah, he'll definitely take that one.
Yeah, it makes any roll real difficult here for Team Morris. Wow, this just in, breaking news, ladies and gentlemen. Nail Yakupov has just been traded by the Edmonton Oilers to the St. Louis Blues for somebody I've never heard of before.
And a third round
pick. And a third round pick. And local hooligan, Bob Popel, in the booth. Not sure who let him in the building, but we'll have to check with security and ensure that doesn't happen again. Bob claims to curl, however, we have yet to see him this year.
Catching it early.
Only in part
B.
That was not at all what Team Morris was looking for.
Yeah, that was they were in a tough spot there after that roll that Ted made, trying to get rid of that one and save their shooter.
I don't think it's going to do much. This is where we threw that, tried that double.
I assume we'll just see Ted just rip this blue out and just make it go away. No concern about sitting there to lie to at this point.
No, okay. You just got to get rid of it. And even if...
Normal weight on the nose.
Even if you leave him the blank or the one, I think Team Appleman would be happy with either of those. And not sure, it might be handshakes. We'll see.
Hard, Sean. Oh. Lots of room. Good sweep.
Yeah, real good throw there by Ted. He certainly didn't need to hang around, but it's nice to do it sometimes. Force your opponent to throw against a couple.
I draw down here. How was that weight?
Stay here, Max.
Well, yeah, that's what I thought.
I guess there has to be some.
This is looking good.
Gonna really have to go on this one, I'm afraid.
Yeah, this looks light, and
sweepers, I got her.
Well, they're dragging her.
That slid nice. Looked like that might come up short, but not a problem, right into the forefoot. So nice draw there by Jim Cotter. They'll pick up their one, and we'll head to the seventh end. It'll be 5-2 for Team Appleman, and they'll have last rock.
One.
In contention here. And I forgot to turn my mic on, so nobody heard that. So it looks like Team Appleman's going to play the tick shot. It's not easy. I've made a couple in my career, as Chris and Steven can attest to the shock of everybody. I do have some curling game every now and again.
Yep. Hard. Hard. Whoa. 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 Whoa.
This one looks
shot out.
Looks pretty good here. Johnny Moe going hard, looking to get rid of it.
How does that work?
Oh, just gets to the boards. That was
put it back anyways.
That looked real good. Just maybe a little bit too much weight.
I think we're good.
You there?
So a little bit of talk there. I guess with the new brooms, from what I can pick up, the skip is allowed to sweep behind the line with a non-conforming broom. But with Johnny Moe coming out to sweep that one above the tee line, apparently that is not allowed. But
mine's good.
In a show of sportsmanship, with it being a new rule, Ted let him replace
mine's
it
nice.
Anyway.
Yeah, John just was bringing the broom back down that I think Jim Cotter threw with,
ooh,
and just forgot to change them with the broom that he had there behind the house. Not a big deal.
If not, we gotta go.
Very, very confusing for those of you not familiar with the new rules. I'm sure we'll see teams take a little bit of time to get used to it, but I'm sure they will make the appropriate adjustments. So things setting up pretty nice here for Team Morris with two center guards, and that one's slipping just back four. If they can get one locked in here, it's going to see Team Appleman have to play a little bit of bailout mode here. And just coming up a little short there, a little tight. Still up front, so they can use it, but certainly not what they were looking for. Just the straight peel there. Try to open her back up. I would imagine you'd see Team Morris throw it back up there.
Center.
Just looking for somewhere. Kind of high to halfway, make the run back double a little longer.
Yes.
Good spot there. I think we'll just see them play the single peel.
Clean. Clean. Throw, Sean. Manny can feel good.
Get ready, just tell me.
Fun times.
Mine's really good.
They playing the come around here, Steve?
Yeah, they're trying to. This looks like a bit light. Line would have been real nice.
Yeah, they just they've really been struggling to find their draw weight out here today.
Yeah, definitely not the Team Morris we're used to seeing. So, bit of a struggle.
I'm sure we'll see them bounce back, and would be very surprised if we didn't see them qualify for the playoff round. This is a triple knockout we got going on here, Steve.
Huh?
You bet. 24 teams,
no,
triple knockout,
going.
So eight qualifiers.
Down.
So
if it hits it.
Still lots of chances with both
right
Team Morris and Team Appleman winning their first games. Definitely lots of curling left, yeah. But going to take a couple extra games to get into the playoff round. Ooh. So Tom Appleman here throwing the high hard one.
Whoa.
Looking to move a bit of granite, and he will get rid of all three and lose his shooter. That is a wonderful shot.
Yeah, that's exactly what they're looking for. They'll like that one.
Yeah, that that could pretty much seal this game here. I think if Team Morris doesn't steal one here, we're gonna probably see handshakes. Although with the amount of misses we've seen, you never know. They might feel like they have a chance, but you know, scoring four in the eighth when you need to is quite difficult to do.
Go around it. No, we're not there.
This one doesn't look good either.
Yep.
Just taking its time to curl there.
Crap in there.
And just sits right beside it, which is not good. And that rock will be easily removed. And
well, you have to hit this one first. You want to try it? I think you just get rid of it. You're gonna put it here, he's gonna go. Just get rid of it, yeah.
Yeah, good call there by Ted. No need to get cute here. Pretty well set up for Team Appleman to at least score here, which is really all they're looking to do. So just gonna wanna hit and hit and roll away here. Does just that.
And with that one, looks like we'll have handshakes.
Obviously. Thanks, Tom, for that.
So obviously Team Morris not happy with or not seeing very good opportunity to steal one or two there that end, and decided to shake hands. So with that, Team Appleman will win of a score of 5-2. They will move on to one of tomorrow's A qualifiers, and Team Morris will drop into the B event. So we'll do a quick score update, and then that'll be it. So in front of us here on sheet six, Brendan Botcher leads Team Willie Liburn 6-3, playing the seventh. Team Lou is leading Team King 4-3, playing the seventh. We have a real good battle on sheet two. Team Corte is up one without against Steve Laycock, playing the seventh. And over on sheet one, it's all tied up between Jason Jacobson and Team Ackerman, with a whole bunch of rocks in play over there this end in the seventh. So we'll be back for tonight's fourth draw at 7:30.